traditional method of solving a linear system. In the previous lesson, we learned how to use substitution. Today, we're going to learn another method. You'll need a few materials with you today. The first is a notebook or some loose leaf paper. Next, you'll need a pencil. You'll also need your Grade 8, Module 4, Lesson 28 student pages. You can find these in your student edition, in your Learn, Practice, Succeed books, or you could scroll down to the bottom of this page and find a link that will lead you to the pages that you'll need. You'll need 3 pages today. You'll also want to grab a ruler, some graph paper, and you'll probably want a calculator. I tell you what, please pause your video. Take as much time as you need and gather all these materials together. Then come on back and we'll get started with our lesson today. Did you find all your materials? All right, my friends, let's get started. Describe how you would solve the following systems algebraically. All right, so yesterday we learned about substitution. Let's think about how we would set these up. I'm not asking you to solve anything, just to think about how you would go about it. Here's the first system. Y equals 3x plus 5, and y equals 8x plus 3. What would be your first step? Since both equations were equal to y, we could write 3x plus 5 is equal to 8x plus 3. This eliminates that y value, and we can solve for x, and then we can substitute back in and solve for y. Okay, let's look at another one. Y equals 7x minus 2, and 2y minus 4x equals 10. We don't have y equals this time. What would your first step be? Are you thinking that you might want to multiply the first equation by 2? That would lead you to 2y is equal to 2 times the quantity 7x minus 2. That could then be substituted in for the 2y in the second equation. This would lead us to 2 times the quantity 7x minus 2 minus 4x is equal to 10. This eliminates that y. Let's look at one more. X equals 6y plus 7, and x equals 10y plus 2. What do you think your first step would be? Did you notice that both equations are equal to x? We could write 6y plus 7 is equal to 10y plus 2. This would eliminate the x value. Then we can solve for y. We can then substitute back in and solve for x. Great. This kind of summed up what we did yesterday in our session. All right, let's take a look at something that's going to set us up for today's session. What do you notice about these three examples? Example 1. If 2 plus 5 equals 7 and 1 plus 9 equals 10, does 2 plus 5 plus 1 plus 9 equal 7 plus 10? Let's think about it. 2 plus 5 is 7, plus 1 is 8, plus 9 is 17. 7 plus 10 is also 17. Those are equivalent. Let's look at example 2. If 1 plus 5 equals 6 and 7 minus 2 equals 5, does 1 plus 5 plus 7 minus 2 equals 6 plus 5. Well, 1 plus 5 is 6, plus 7 is 13, 13 minus 2 is 11, 6 plus 5 is 11, 11 equals 11, those are equivalent. If negative 3 plus 11 equals 8, and 2 plus 1 equals 3, does negative 3 plus 11 plus 2 plus 1 equal 8 plus 3? Well, negative 3 plus 11 is 8, plus 2 is 10, plus 1 is 11. All right, 11 on the left-hand side would equal 8 plus 3, which is That's 11 as well. So 11 equals 11. So we can add equivalent expressions and still have an equivalence. So we can add the left-hand sides of the equations from two of the equations and equal them to the addition of the right-hand sides. All right, that's going to help us with what we're going to do today. I'm going to switch over to my document camera, and then we're going to do some work together. Let's take a look at example one. These are in your pages. You can follow along and do the work with me. Use what you noticed about adding equivalent expressions to solve the following system by elimination. Well, we have a system of 6x minus 5y equals 21 and 2x plus 5y equals negative 5. I'm thinking that I can't use substitution for this one. It would be really messy. So there has to be another way. We're going to think about this in terms of elimination. Well, look, I have a negative 5y and a positive 5y. That looks like, that looks like a zero pair. Let's write it with the left-hand sides added together and the right-hand sides added together. And then let's think about this equation. So we have the equation 6x minus 5y plus 2x plus 5y is equal to 21 minus 5, or 21 plus negative 5. Okay, I have a lot going on that left-hand side. Let's see if I use the commutative property to bring the x's together and the y's together. Some of you might want to move just to combining like terms. That's absolutely fine. And in the future, that's what we'll do. But on this example, let's move those x's together and those y's together so that we can see what we're doing. So 6x plus 2x minus 5y plus 5y is equal to 21 minus 5. All right, well, we have a zero pair, negative 5y and positive 5y. They're going to eliminate each other. So we're going to be left with just x's. 6x plus 2x is equal to 21 minus 5. Well, this looks like an equation I can deal with. I no longer have the y, so I'm only dealing with one variable. Can I combine like terms on both sides of the equal sign? Sure I can. So 6x plus 2x is 8x, is equal to 21 minus 5 would be 16. What would be our next step? Are you thinking to multiply by the reciprocal? I completely agree with you. So 1/8 times 8x would equal, that multiplication property of equality, 1/8 times 16. I have to do it to the right-hand side as well. This would give us a coefficient of 1 on the x. So x is equal to, and 1/8 of 16 happens to be 2. We now have our x value. We have to substitute our x value into one of the two equations. It doesn't matter which equation you pick. I'm going to pick the second one only because I like the 2 times 2 as opposed to the 6 times 2. But truly, it doesn't make any difference. So 2x plus 5y is equal to negative 5. So 2, our x value we said was equal to 2, so I'm going to substitute that value in. Plus 5y is equal to negative 5. We have to multiply 2 times 2. We would get 4 plus 5y is equal to negative 5. What would our next step be? Yeah, we have to move those numbers so that they're all on one side. Because remember, we want a variable on one side and a constant on the other side. So we need to create that zero pair. 4 is positive, so 4 minus 4 would create that zero pair. Plus 5y is equal to negative 5 minus 4. Well, we eliminated the 4s, so 5y is equal to negative 9. Can we divide both sides by 5 or multiply by 1 fifth? Yeah, we could multiply by the reciprocal. 1 fifth of 5y would equal 1 fifth of negative 9. So y would equal negative 9 fifths. We've now created our ordered pair. So our ordered pair that at where the lines intersect would be 2, negative 9 fifths. We could graph these two equations and see if we're correct. Well, negative 9 fifths is almost negative 2. So let's take a look at the graph. We can see the point of intersection at 2, negative 9 fifths. Great job, guys. Let's take a look at example 2. All right, let's take a look at example 2. Solve the following system by elimination. Negative 2x plus 7y equals 5, and 4x minus 2y equals 14. Well, I'm looking at this, and this is not quite as clear as example 1. I don't have any zero pairs. But I'm thinking I have a positive 4x and a negative 2x. Could I write an equivalent equation for the first one that would make a negative 4x to get that zero pair? Yeah, maybe I can multiply the equation by 2. Let's give it a try. 2 times the equation negative 2x plus 7y equals 5. So this would transform into negative 4x plus 14y equals 10. Okay, what if I rewrote the system just so that I could see it? Negative 4x plus 14y equals 10, that's that equivalent equation. And then we had an equation of 4x minus 2y equals 14. Well, here's our system. Do you see a zero pair now? Yeah, I do too. All right, so let's write this all together. So we would get negative 4x plus 14y plus 4x minus 2y is equal to 10 plus 14. Well, we have a zero pair with that negative 4x and that positive 4x. All right, they eliminate each other. So we get 14y minus 2y is equal to 10 plus 14. Notice that now we just have y's and we can solve for y. So we've eliminated that x term. This would be 12y equals 24. We can combine those like terms and transform the equation. We can look at 12y equals 24. How can we get a coefficient of 1? You're right. We can multiply by 1 12th. 1 12th of 12y would give us that 1y. Well, we need to use that multiplication property of equality to multiply 1 12th on the other side as well. So we would get y is equal to 2. Remember before when we said we could substitute into either equation? I'm taking a look at this. I think I still want to use that second equation only because I don't want to deal with the 7. But that's truly just my preference. It doesn't make any difference. 4x minus 2y is equal to 14. 4x minus 2, substitute in the 2, so times 2, is equal to 14. 4x minus 4 equals 14. Now we need to create a zero pair to have all our constants on one side. So 4x minus 4 plus 4 is equal to, Oh, there's that addition property of equality, 14 plus 4. This eliminates, and we transform into 4x equals 18. How are we going to get a coefficient of 1? You're right. We're going to multiply by 1/4. 1/4 of 4x is equal to, oh, multiplication property of equality, 1/4 times 18. Well, this is going to transform into x equals 9/2. How did I get 9/2? Well, 18 divided by 4, or 18/4, can be renamed as 9/2. All right, so we have the ordered pair 9/2, 2. Well, what is 9/2? 9 divided by 2 is 4, with 1 left over, so 4 1/2. Let's take a look at a graph and see if we're intersecting at 4 1/2, 2. Notice that we're intersecting at 4 1/2 for our x value and up 2 for the y value. So our intersection point is that 9/2, 2. Great job, guys. Let's do one more example together. Here's example 3. We're going to solve by elimination. We have the system 7x minus 5y equals negative 2, and 3x minus 3y equals 7. I don't see a multiple of 7, and I don't see a multiple of 5, and I don't see anything that I can do with that 3x, 3y to transform it to look like 7x minus 5y. What about if I multiplied both equations and I created something? Well, that might work. I think I might try to eliminate these x's. So one of them is going to have to be negative, and one's going to have to be positive in order to form that zero pair. Well, what about if I multiply the first equation by negative 3 and the second equation by a positive 7? Let's give that a try and see if the x's will eliminate. So negative 3 times the equation 7x minus 5y is equal to negative 2. We can create an equivalent equation of negative 21x plus 15y equal to positive 6. Let's take a look at the other equation. I said that I think I want to multiply it by 7. Notice that now I have a negative 21x. What would create the zero pair? Yeah, a positive 21x. So to get a 3x to a positive 21x, we'd have to multiply by 7. So we need to create an equivalent equation by multiplying the whole equation by 7. That equation would be 21x minus 21y equals 49. Let's write the system again with our equivalent equations. Notice that now we have that zero pair. Let's write it out all together. Negative 21x plus 15y plus 21x minus 21y is equal to 6 plus 49. Here's our zero pair. They eliminate. So we no longer have x's. We're left with 15y minus 21y equals 55. We can combine like terms on the left-hand side, and get negative 6y is equal to 55. How can we get a coefficient of 1? Yes, we can multiply by the reciprocal. Negative 1/6 times negative 6y is equal to 55 times negative 1/6. We're using the multiplication property of equality. So y is equal to negative 55/6. We now have to pick one of our original equations to substitute back into. I'm thinking I want to use the 3x minus 3y equals 7. Doesn't really make any difference. You could certainly use that first equation. 3x minus 3y is equal to 7. We have to substitute in our y value. 3x minus 3 times negative 55/6 is equal to 7. So 3x plus, because I have a negative and a negative, which would multiply to a positive, 3 divides into 6 twice, so I would get 55/2 is equal to 7. Now we need to create a zero pair. 3x plus 55/2 minus 55/2 is equal to, I'm going to transform or rename 7 into halves, and this would be 14/2 minus that 55/2. That'll just help me do the math. 3x is equal to negative 41/2. We need to get a coefficient of 1. How are we going to do that? Yes, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal of 3. So 1/3 times 3x is equal to 1/3 times negative 41/2. We had to use the multiplication property of equality. So x is equal to negative 41/6. Great job. Now we have our x and y values, negative 41/6 and negative 55/6. That would be our ordered pair. Great jobs, my friends. Now it's your turn. I'm going to give you an opportunity to practice some on the exercises. Here's exercise 1. You're being asked to determine the solution of the system by using elimination. And then, once you've done the algebra, graph it. Graph those two equations and see if the intersection point is the same as the one that you found algebraically. Take as much time as you need. Pause the video, do the work, and then when you're ready, come on back and we'll look at it together. Did you notice that you had a zero pair with that negative 7y and that positive 7y? So we can write it out. So you would get 6x minus 7y plus 3x plus 7y equals negative 10 minus 8. You can then do the work and you should have found that your answer was negative 2, negative 2/7. Why don't you take a look at my work if you need to? Take as much time as you need. Pause the video if you need to look it over. Did you graph this? Here's what the graph looks like. Notice that you have an intersection point at negative 2, negative 2/7. Here's the point of intersection. All right, let's take a look at exercise 2. Here's exercise 2. You're going to follow the same process that you did for exercise 1. Solve this algebraically using elimination. If you need to, go back to the examples that we already did. Once you have your solution, Graph the two lines and see if the intersection point is at the same point that you found algebraically. When you're ready, unpause the video, come on back, and we'll talk about it together. Are you ready to take a look? I thought about this one and I thought, well, I'm going to multiply the first equation by negative 5 to find that equivalent equation. I got an equivalent equation of negative 5x plus 20y is equal to negative 35. This gives me the system of negative 5x plus 20y equals negative 35, and 5x plus 9y equals 6. Well, there's that zero pair that I circled for you. Then I did some work, and I found that once I eliminated the x's, I could solve for y and got negative 1. I then substituted the negative 1 into that first equation and got 3 as my x value. If you need to, pause the video and take a look at the work. Did you graph this? This is what my graph looked like. Notice that the two lines intersect at 3, negative 1. All right, let's look at one more example together. Here's number 3. Do the exact same process one more time. See if you can solve this with elimination. Again, if you need to go back to our examples or our previous exercises, please do so. Then, once you've solved it algebraically, take some time and graph it and see if your intersection point matches. Did you work out exercise 3? Did you notice that you had to multiply both equations to find something equivalent? I decided to work with my y values because they were already the opposite signs. I had a negative 3y and a positive 5y. So I decided to multiply the first equation by 5 and got 10x minus 15y is equal to negative 25. And I multiplied the second equation by 3. This transformed it into 9x plus 15y equals 3. I could then think about the system of these equivalent equations. Once I did that, I had those zero pairs. And when I did out the work, I got an answer of negative 22 19ths, 17 19ths. That's my ordered pair. If you need to, take a look at the work. Did you graph this? Here's the graph. If you look, it's negative 22 19ths. That's a little bit more than negative 1. And 17 19ths, which is not quite 1. And that's that intersection point. All right, I have one more thing I would like to look at with you today. Let's go back to my PowerPoint and think about some equations. Let's think about which method you think is the most efficient to solve these systems. Here's the first system. Y equals 5x minus 19 and 3x plus 11 equals y. Do you think it would be easier to use substitution or elimination? I'm thinking substitution. Each equation is equal to y. So therefore, we could just substitute those values and we could get 3x plus 11 equals 5x minus 19. Let's look at this one. 2x minus 9y equals 7 and x plus 9y equals 5. Are you thinking substitution or elimination? I was thinking elimination. The y term can be eliminated because they have coefficients that are opposites. Notice we have a negative 9y and a positive 9y. We were talking about those zero pairs. What about this one? 4x minus 3y equals negative 8 and x plus 7y equals 4. I thought this would be best as elimination. When multiplying the second equation by negative 4, it will lead to the elimination of the x term from the equation. So we'll develop that zero pair. We did that today. What about this one? X plus y equals negative 3, and 6x plus 6y equals 6. Is this elimination? But wait a minute. If we multiply the first equation by negative 6 to create a zero pair for those x's, what's going to happen? We're going to eliminate not only the x term, but also the y term, because we'll have negative 6x and negative 6y. The equation will then become 0 equals 24. Well, that's not right. There's no solution. What type of lines are these? These lines are parallel. All right, you did a lot of work today. Let's sum up what we did. Let's think about some main points of the lesson. We know how to solve a system by eliminating one of the variables. In some cases, we will have to multiply one or even both of the given equations by a constant in order to eliminate a variable. We know that some systems are solved more efficiently by elimination than by other methods. Sometimes it's easier to use substitution. This is all in your lesson summary. You can find that on top of your problem set. You did a great job today. I'm always so proud of the work that you do. I can't wait to work with you again soon. I hope that you have a wonderful day.
Attention, Harrisburg School District parents and guardians, your voice matters. Please take a moment to complete our newest Return to School Family Survey, located on the district website at www.hbgsd.us and our district Facebook or Twitter sites. The survey is available in English and Spanish. Thank you in advance for completing this important survey.
Hi everyone, my name is Monique. I'm a registered nurse in peri anesthesia. Peri what, might you ask? Big word, I know. Come join me and I'll tell you all about it. So my specialty is unique in that my department consists of three separate areas within the surgery world. First being pre-op. This is where I get the patient ready for surgery. Meet Mr. Bear. That includes having them get completely undressed to put on this fancy gown with these matching fancy slippers. These slippers are unique in that they have special grips on the bottom to prevent the patient from falling down. So we ask the patient a bunch of questions about their health and their history, and that is to make sure that we are giving them the best care possible throughout their stay. Once we have all of our information gathered, our prep is complete, and all questions are answered, we whisk them off to the OR in the stretcher, which is similar to a bed on wheels. And they basically say, not just goodbye, but see you later to their families. So Mr. Bear's all ready for the OR. Next, you'll meet my friend Rachel. You'll see that Rachel and I, even though we are both nurses, we have completely different roles working in the surgical world. Stay tuned and she'll tell you all about her OR experience.
Hi everyone, my name is Rachel. Monique just mentioned me. I'm a registered nurse in the operating room and I'm going to talk to you today about how my team and I work together to keep our patients safe. Not only do Monique and I work together very well, her in her peri-anesthesia position and me in the operating room, but I have a bunch of people that I'm going to talk to you about today that are also on my team back in the OR. So first I'm going to tell you all about my outfit because I know you're all giggling from home about my funny hat. I come to the hospital in the morning and I actually change into my scrubs because these scrubs cannot be worn outside where the germs are. I also cover my hair and my shoes and my mouth and nose so that I don't spread germs. Now for today's purposes, and because we're not in a real operating room, I'm not gonna have a mask on. But normally going into an operating room, I would have a mask on and make sure that my nose and mouth are covered. So now I'm gonna tell you about my team back in the operating room. It's of course the doctor who does the surgery and a doctor who puts the patient to sleep. He's called an anesthesiologist, another big word. A surgical technologist, and then myself, the nurse. Every person on my team has a very important role in the operating room to keep this patient safe. The doctor is the one who's going to do the surgery, and he has all the knowledge to perform the surgery safely. The anesthesiologist is going to put the patient to sleep, our teddy bear is our patient today, and make sure that they are breathing the whole time that they are sleeping. They monitor this with fancy machines, and they're constantly up there looking at those machines during the surgery. The surgical technologist is in charge of everything that's sterile in the room. We have a sterile field, and here everything is blue, so we say if it's blue, don't touch it. I'm going to show you some things that the surgical technologist works with, so I am going to touch this for this instance. But they have to wear a sterile gown and a sterile pair of gloves when they're working with this stuff back here on the table. When the surgeon comes in and he helps with the operation, he will also put on a sterile gown and sterile gloves, and the surgical technologist will dress him for that. The scrub knows and understands the purpose of every instrument on this back table. They set up and organize this table, and they're in charge of handling the instruments and handing them off to the surgeon when he asks for one. The surgical technologist knows the name of all the instruments. For example, what do you think this instrument looks like? Did you say a scissor? Because if you did, you're right. It is a scissor. But let's look closely at the back table at all of the different types of scissors that we have. They all look different and all are used for a different purpose. Our scrub technologist, our surgical technologist, is the one that knows the name of each individual scissor back here on the table. Because we don't just call that a scissor, we have a specific name. For example, we have a Metzenbaum scissor, a Mayo scissor, a Potts scissor is one that has this little curve to it. So they have all that knowledge back here with all these instruments. Very important. Now we're going to move to my role as a nurse in the OR. I help assist wherever it is needed. I help to position the patient so that the doctor has access to the surgery site, and I also prep the patient's surgery site with a solution that kills the germs. This cleans better than soap. I also have to count all of the instruments, sharps, and sponges that the surgical technologist has on their table. We count these instruments, sharps, and sponges multiple times throughout the procedure to make sure we know where everything is and so that is not left in a patient. During the procedure, I open supplies that they need and do the charting on the computer. At the end of the procedure, we're going to safely move the patient back over onto the stretcher that they came into the OR with, and I'm going to take them to the recovery room, which is another part of perianesthesia. So we're going to meet Monique again, and she's going to tell you all about how we wake this patient up and they recover.
Hi again, it's Monique here. So next stop is the PACU. This is known as the post-anesthesia care unit. Long fancy word again, but PACU for short. So patients here are really sleepy after their visit to the OR because of the medications they received during surgery. As they arrive to us asleep, our job as the PACU nurse is to watch them closely until they awaken from pleasant dreams. During their time here with us, we provide them with warm blankets, some oxygen, and a quiet place to wake peacefully to. Once they are awake, some may be uncomfortable, but no worries. We give them medication to make them feel better. Afterwards, and after I feel that they are ready to get up and they're moving and they feel awake and they present safely, they will then be sent to the final stop, which is the discharge area. So discharge is where patients reunite with their families and they get ready to go home. Others may need an overnight stay or two and will see their family upstairs in their assigned rooms. So this job is so much fun. Every day is different. Every person is different. There's different surgeries and different patients that I get to meet. I'm never bored, but I want to thank you for coming today and spending time to learn about the surgical world.
Welcome to my station about dental health. My station's topic is Healthy is a Cavity-Free Smile. My name is Mrs. Butera, and I'm the dental hygienist for Harrisburg School District. So having a cavity-free smile is more than just brushing your teeth two or three times a day and flossing in between. Those are very good habits to have, but today you'll learn more information about how to keep plaque germs, also known as sugar bugs, away. So first, let's talk about the structure of a tooth. There are three layers of a tooth. The enamel, which is on the outer side, the part that you see in the mirror when you smile, the center part, which is the dentin, it's a little bit softer, and on the center is the pulp. It's the nerve center of your tooth that tells you your tooth is alive, and you can tell this because sometimes your tooth gets a little shiver when you bite into something cold. Next, let's talk about plaque. Plaque is the icky, sticky, ooey, gooey coating of germs that you notice most when you wake up in the morning because it might give you some bad breath. The fact about plaque is that plaque germs love sugar. In fact, they need them to make them strong. The bad thing is, when they get strong, they might cause a cavity, which is a hole in the layers of your teeth. Sometimes you get a toothache if that hole gets too close to the center, nerve center of your tooth. So we get rid of plaque germs by brushing and flossing your teeth, your gums, and your tongue. Plaque germs can hide everywhere in your mouth, so imagine playing hide and seek with the plaque germs when you brush. If you were a plaque germ, would you hide in the front or the back? That's right, in the back. So do a better job of brushing your molars in the back to get rid of those sticky germs. So next we're going to talk about sugar. Everybody likes sweet stuff, especially now and then. And sugar can be in foods that we eat. Candy, cookies, sodas. Those are all things we should have just once in a while. But unfortunately, all foods can have some amount of sugar in them. So today we're going to talk about sodas, because when you take a drink of soda, it coats your tooth with sugar. The most common way that we get sugar on our teeth is by the drinks that we drink. And the sugar turns to acid from the plaque on your teeth with every sip. Did you know that each can of soda has about 140 calories and 39 grams of sugar? When you think of grams of sugar, it might be confusing because we don't usually use grams, we use teaspoons. So I have a little math problem, because I know you guys are good at math, to figure out grams and teaspoons. So if there's 39 grams of sugar, you're going to divide by 4 and you come up with almost 9.5 teaspoons of sugar. That's a lot of sugar. If you drink 2 sodas a day or you have a refill, that could be almost 20 grams of sugar. So if you have that every day for a month, it's a 5-pound bag of sugar that you've consumed. That's a lot of sugar. And it takes 100 miles of walking to get rid of the excess calories that come from this non-nutritive drink. If you don't burn it off, you store it as fat. Here is 2.5 pounds of fat, and that's how much you would store just by 2 drinks a day alone. Kind of frightening, right? And I measured it out into a bag so you can see what that sugar looks like. This is 18.5 teaspoons coming from 2 cans of soda. That's a lot of sugar. Water is best if you're thirsty, because water has 0 sugar and it does not harm your teeth in any way. So healthy habits for your teeth are to brush your teeth and floss every day. And I have my friend here, Allie the alligator, with me to show you the best way to brush your teeth. There's 3 sides of your teeth: the front side, the back side, and the flat side. So you should brush your teeth every day on those 3 sides. Putting your teeth together, little circles are best because plaque germs do not like to be tickled. That's the front side, side number 1. Side number 2 is the back side, along the inside part of your teeth. Number 3 is the flat side. So now you've just brushed all 3 places that plaque germs can hide: the front side, the back side, and the flat side. Your bonus place is your tongue, so that way you won't have bad breath. The second healthy habit is to visit your dentist twice a year for a checkup and to think about your drink. Choose water most often so you have less sugar attacks on your teeth with the sugar bugs. So there you have it. Brush your teeth, visit the dentist, and think about your drink. Question of the day is, too many sugary drinks can cause, A, you guessed it, a cavity. So the more you brush and the more you think you drink, the less chance of cavities you'll have. Thank you for visiting my station. Have a great day.
And I want to say welcome to our the Harrisburg community who's joining us today for this informational session on our Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy program. We're very excited to be here with you today. Joining me for the presentation is Dr. Marisol Craig. Many of you know Dr. Craig. She's been with Harrisburg School District for over 18 years. She is the principal for the Cougar Academy and is also taking the lead for our Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy program. And so I'm pleased that Dr. Craig was able to join us, and she will walk you through the pieces of the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy program that, again, we're very excited to be able to offer to our community and our families within the Harrisburg School District. A few opening comments before I turn the presentation over to Dr. Craig. There is a Google form that is online on our website. There's a form that is in English and there's a form in Spanish where you can submit questions as we're going through the presentation. Dr. Craig and I will then take the questions and we'll provide answers in the form of a frequently asked question document, which we will have released within the next 48 hours, which will, again, respond to the questions you may have as we walk through the presentation. In addition, within the next 48 hours, we are going to have the PowerPoint presentation that we'll review today translated into Spanish and posted on our website and our social media sites for the public's view. And so again, those will be both available and posted within 48 hours of this afternoon's presentation. So again, I want to thank you, especially during these extremely difficult and challenging times, for joining us for today's informational session. Education has been pushed to the limit over the last 3 to 4 months. And we realized as a school district that we needed to become more versatile and we needed to have more offerings for you, our students and families within the Harrisburg School District. And that's really where Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy has come from. It was a concept that we were discussing last year when we arrived in Harrisburg, but certainly since COVID-19 has changed the landscape of how we live and how we educate our students. There has been tremendous focus and effort by the team to bring forward this Virtual Learning Academy option for you in the Harrisburg School District. So again, Dr. Craig will be walking you through the details of the program. And again, we're very excited to have her here today and have her leadership in really getting the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy off the ground and running for the 2021 school year. So what is the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy program? What it is, it's a full-time remote learning option for Harrisburg residents at no cost to our families. So this is an offering that if you're enrolled in the Harrisburg School District, you have full access to this offering for the 2021 school year and moving forward. Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy provides a premier full-time online educational experience that will give any student flexibility through a customized learning path. And Dr. Craig will talk about asynchronous and synchronous learning models during the presentation today and the flexibility that an asynchronous learning model can provide to our families in the Harrisburg School District. And HVLA will allow our students to work in a safe environment at their own pace, reducing the pressure to work within structured timelines required in a traditional brick and mortar setting. In addition, from a safety perspective, given the COVID-19 situation, it gives our families an option to have learning right from home without having to come into a school brick and mortar setting. So I would now like to turn the presentation over to Dr. Craig, who will walk you through the exciting details of the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy. Dr. Craig.
Thank you, Mr. Selmer. First, I'd like to do a short introduction and hello to our Spanish families in Spanish. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that first, and then we'll move on to the presentation.
Buenas tardes. Mi nombre es la doctora Craig. Soy la directora de la Academia de Aprendizaje Virtual de Harrisburg. Estoy muy emocionada de estar aquí hoy con ustedes para presentarles nuestra nueva escuela virtual. Nosotros sabemos lo preocupados que han estado nuestros padres por el comienzo de la escuela, pero esta opción virtual podría ser una solución para usted y su familia. La mayor parte de esta presentación de hoy se realizará en inglés, pero será traducida y publicada en nuestra página de web para nuestras familias hispanohablantes. Gracias.
Okay, so thank you. We're going to go ahead and go into the presentation. And the first question here is, what is the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy? So it is a full-time remote learning option for Harrisburg residents at no additional cost. HVLA will provide a premier full-time online learning experience that will give every student the flexibility they need to work and also have a customized learning pathway. It will allow students to work in a safe environment at their own pace, reducing the pressure to work within structured timelines as they would in a regular brick and mortar school program. So what does HVLA offer? HVLA has to offer a kindergarten through 12th grade curriculum. We also offer every student who is part of HVLA a computer and technical support to be able to accomplish their goals and finish their online courses. Each student also receives a Chromebook at no cost. And each student will receive a personalized learning pathway. We also offer a high quality standards-based curriculum. The resource that we are using is called Ingenuity, and the curriculum is K-12, as previously mentioned. We also offer experienced, certified online teachers and instructors. For our high school and middle school students, Ingenuity also offers online guided notes to help support their learning. In addition, we offer audio and video meeting times with instructional support and ongoing academic support and tutoring with our successful academic coaches as needed. Flexibility to work from anywhere, so our students will be able to work at home or from wherever they will be working on a regular basis to complete their online work. We also offer recorded instruction to support student learning, an emphasis on social-emotional learning, and for our high school students, dual enrollment, internships, and AP courses will be available to help support their learning. So all students who are involved with HVLA are considered Harrisburg School District students. Therefore, all our students can participate in any Harrisburg School District special event or extracurricular activities. A bonus for our students as well, even though they are part of the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy, they will be able to earn a Harrisburg High School diploma.
Regardless of the circumstances this fall, school districts that partner with the Montgomery Virtual Program are ready for the upcoming school year. With MVP, students have access to an extensive catalog of core, elective, and advanced course options that are PA core aligned, taught by highly qualified teachers, and meet the rigorous standards of a mastery-based educational platform. MVP partners with public and private schools throughout the state of Pennsylvania to provide access to high-level educational content and establish a support network that ensures students have the opportunity to be successful in an online learning environment, all while remaining a member of your local school community and continuing your path toward a high school degree from your home school district. As educators, we are prepared for the fall and ready to embrace the realities of what school may need to look like. We provide built-in accessibility features, engaging video-based content, and embedded opportunities to create synchronous learning environments that can meet flexible scheduling needs. And we have the data to prove that our platforms can provide successful outcomes for diverse learners. MVP is flexible, supportive, and always on. Let us know how we can help.
I wanted to move into how we were delivering instruction at HVLA. And so there are two types of instruction when we
talk about online education, synchronous instruction and asynchronous instruction. Synchronous instruction are when students and teachers are working together and interacting in a digital space concurrently. So there will be opportunities for teachers and students to work in this way. However, with HVLA, most students will be working asynchronously, which means teachers will post direct instructional videos and assignments, other learning materials online. Students will engage with this material and complete their work at their own pace within a 1 week interval. However, even though students are doing their work online and independently, students will still have the opportunity to connect directly with their teachers and tutors for direct support.
For families seeking a full-time virtual learning option for their elementary students, Edgenuity is proud to offer a virtual curriculum and instruction covering kindergarten through fifth grade. Edgenuity offers virtual students a full suite of more than 30 elementary courses, including electives like physical education, health, keyboarding, art, recorders, and scratch coding. Each course includes a full year of standards-aligned, research-based content with lessons logically organized into modules. If necessary, Edgenuity also provides a highly qualified state-certified teacher to work with families every step of the way. Students are introduced to new concepts and given ample opportunity to practice new skills through text, video, and interactives. Previously learned concepts are reviewed throughout the year to strengthen the student's understanding. Videos are used to support the understanding of new concepts throughout the course. Embedded interactives allow students to practice newly learned concepts and receive immediate feedback. Worksheets are included as another method of practicing each concept throughout the year. Each worksheet is provided as a PDF or is available in a workbook for an additional cost. Students will scan or photograph these worksheets to submit to the teacher. Lessons include brief quizzes to check understanding, and each module has a summative assessment. Students may also be assessed through benchmark assessments, synchronous live sessions with a teacher, or hands-on projects. A list of materials is provided in each lesson and for each course. Students are expected to have typical school supplies for most courses, but other materials may be needed for some lessons, especially in science. English language arts courses offer a balanced literacy program, including instruction in reading, writing, fluency, vocabulary, grammar, and other important elements of language. Students will have weekly independent reading assignments, including novel studies in the upper grades. The learning coach will receive guidance to help students to choose and procure these books. To practice fluency skills, students will have opportunities to record audio and read aloud with the teacher during live synchronous sessions. Math courses build a foundation for mathematical thinking as students learn about numbers, counting, measurement, geometry, operations, and algebraic thinking, using plenty of interactive tools, hands-on activities, and real-world examples. Science courses provide a rich multimedia experience for students, using a mixture of exploring the world around them, combined with hands-on experiences or labs using nature or common household items. In social studies courses, students learn more about the world by exploring the community around them, studying the history of the United States and other countries, and experiencing cultures from around the world. While learning, students have access to a variety of on-demand support tools, including an on-screen reader, translator, dictionary, picture dictionary, and screen mask. Courses require the support of a learning coach, a parent, grandparent, or other designated adult. The learning coach may guide the student through lessons, discuss what is being taught, facilitate hands-on learning, and communicate with the teacher. The resources for each course include guidelines for the learning coach to facilitate learning, including how to schedule the day, set up a learning space, and submit assignments. Each lesson has a learning coach tab with information to help the learning coach guide the student through the lesson, including learning objectives, prerequisite skills, and any materials needed. Teachers have access to a variety of tools and reports to support student success. To personalize learning for each student, a teacher may modify the course by removing, reordering, or adjusting content, or adding in teacher-created lessons or items from the library. Teachers support students by reviewing submitted work and providing feedback through text, audio, or video. Synchronous sessions offer an opportunity for teachers to check in with your student, administer assessments, and discuss grades and goals. Teachers are in frequent communication to assist with any questions and encourage student success. Edgenuity's virtual learning solution for elementary students delivers age-appropriate, engaging lessons designed to develop a lifelong love of learning. Edgenuity, where learning clicks.
Welcome to Edgenuity, where learning clicks. Once you've logged in, you'll see a tile for each course or program you currently have active. Each tile will give you some information about your progress and achievements so far. If you're on track, your progress will appear in blue. If you're ahead, you'll see your progress in green. But if you see your progress shown in red, it means you've fallen behind. You'll need to put in some extra time to get caught up. On some tiles, you can also view your course grade. Notice that this student has an overall grade of 95% in foundational math. That means they're currently earning an A on the work they've completed so far. Great job! It's almost time to get started in your online course. Remember to keep these tips for success in mind. First, take notes on what you're learning. You might use e-notes and you might use a pen and paper, but rephrasing what you learn in your own words helps you pay attention and remember what you've learned. Second, stay on pace. Make sure your progress bar is in the blue or even in the green. If you fall too far behind, it gets hard to catch up later. Ask for help when you need it. If you don't understand something, tell your teacher. He or she can explain it in a different way and point you toward other online resources. You are responsible for your own success, but you don't have to do it alone. And finally, avoid plagiarism. It's never okay to copy and paste other people's work and submit it as your own. Even if you find text online and you don't know who the author is, you do know that the author isn't you. You can't pass someone else's work off as your own. So always cite your sources or rephrase ideas in your own words. Now we're ready to jump into a lesson. To get started, you can click Next Activity, or you can click anywhere else on the tile to go to the course map. Click a tile to go to the course map now. This is your course map. From here, you can view the entire structure of your course. If your teacher has set a target date for you, you can check the due dates in your course map to see exactly what you need to do each day to stay on track. As long as you complete all your assignments for the day, you'll stay on pace. You can also view your e-notes here. As you work through the course, you may see alerts appear. For example, if you fall behind, you'll see a message telling you how much work you need to do to catch up. If you have feedback from a teacher, you'll see an alert like this. And if you forget to submit an activity for your teacher to grade, you'll see a reminder like this. Don't forget to submit your work once you finish it. A few other helpful things to notice. Want to switch courses? You can navigate among your active courses right here, or go back to the home page. Need help using Edgenuity? Visit the Help Center, where you'll find videos, resources you can download, and frequently asked questions. On the course map, most activities will show up as grayed out and locked unless your teacher has allowed you to move freely throughout the course. To work on any activity that's unlocked, click the activity title. This activity is a warm-up or introduction. Let's take a look. This activity starts with a video. You can pause and rewind the video at any time using the video controls here. If you've already watched the video the whole way through once, you can fast forward to the part you want to see again. However, you can't fast forward through any video segment you haven't watched yet. You do need to watch every video once all the way through. You can control the volume here. and you can turn captions on here. It's important to know that most of the important information you'll be tested on will be taught here in the videos. So pay attention and take good notes. You'll find your e-notes or digital notebook here. You can take notes at any time. Pause the video if you want to, or if you're a fast typist, you can take notes while the teacher is talking. Once you add a note to your notebook, you can go back and edit it if you need to. Just click the note and it'll appear in the e-notes text box. Edit your note and click Save. Now you may find that you want to add more to your notes. In advanced mode, you can use formatting tools like tables, an equation editor, a symbol palette, and bulleted lists. We find that students who take notes tend to do better on quizzes and tests. Taking the time to write down the important ideas in your own words will help you process and remember what you learn. So use your e-notes. Another helpful tool is the glossary, found on this second tab. All the vocabulary words for the lesson will appear here, but you can also look up any word you want. To go back to the lesson word list, just close the word lookup window. The third tab contains a transcript of the current activity. You can view this transcript in English, or you can translate it into any supported language, as long as you have the translation enabled. Just open the transcript and select your language here. Sometimes the video will pause, and you'll be asked to complete a task. On any task, you can use the tools in your toolbar. In math and science courses, you can use the built-in calculators to solve problems. Depending on the course, you might have access to a standard calculator, a graphing calculator, or other specialized calculators. In any course, you can highlight text. This can help you pay attention as you read, especially when you're asked to read extended articles and stories. If you have Read Aloud enabled, you can hear text read aloud. Just highlight what you want to hear and press the Read Aloud button.
The runner travels.
If you have translation enabled, you can change the languages of most on-screen text here. Some of these languages also work with the Read Aloud tool, so try it out.
Il grafico mostra la distanza.
Now, when you want to leave an activity, just click the Home button in the upper left corner of your screen. Don't worry, we'll always save your work. When you come back to the activity, you'll be able to pick up where you left off. Now it's time to get started in your online course.
Again, those are the platforms that we're offering through the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy. We believe, again, as Dr. Craig mentioned, there's a number of school districts across the state and outside of Pennsylvania that are using the Edgenuity platforms for their remote learning options. We think it's a robust option that will provide great flexibility and great instruction from home for our students and families within Harrisburg School District. One thing I would say, when you talk about success online and remote instruction, even though there's flexibility, one of the things that we'll work on and Dr. Craig's team will work on will be helping as far as there needs to be consistency and structure, even when you're on an online platform learning from home. So again, while that flexibility is important, certainly some structure, routine is equally important when you're at home learning online. So again, given Dr. Craig's expertise with the Cougar Academy, certainly her and her team can offer those type of thoughts and suggestions as you're learning, how you're gonna support your student learners at home through this online learning option. Dr. Craig, any final thoughts for our students, families, community this afternoon?
Okay, so what kind of instructional supports will HVLA offer? So we have highly qualified, certified, they're PA certified core teachers who will be available for support. So students will log in, they will do their assignments. If they need a one-on-one session with a teacher, they would create a meet time with the teacher and would be able to review their work with their certified teacher as needed. We will also be providing special education teachers. I've received a lot of questions around if my child has an IEP,
Will there be teachers available to help support their IEP? Yes, HBLA will have special education teachers available. In addition, I've received some questions around English as a second language. HBLA will have teachers available to support our English language learners. In addition, reading specialists will be available to support our students, especially at the primary level where we know they need a lot of reading support. And finally, there will be opportunity for students if they need additional tutoring or one-on-one sessions beyond what the teacher is available to offer. We do have some teachers that will be available to help support in a tutoring way for ELA and math. We will also have academic advising by our counselor. We do have a full-time counselor that will be available for all our students. And we also will have available our social worker to do outreach work with all our students and families. We mentioned earlier that because the students who are part of HVLA are Harrisburg students, they will be able to participate in any of our extracurricular activities offered by Harrisburg School District. So some of those activities might be athletics, cheerleading, prom, band, chorus, ROTC, the National Honors Program, History Day, graduation, literacy nights, clubs, assemblies, picture days, and et cetera. In addition, we want to make sure that all our children and parents are successful. And so we do have a plan of support for our students for logging in questions, for issues that may arise regarding using your computers. So that will be available for all our students and parents as well. And for our high school students, again, academic advancement programs. So we talked earlier about dual enrollment. We have advanced placement courses that will be available for all our students as well. And we also have gifted program support in place for students who are eligible to receive the gifted services. So how do I enroll in HBLA? Step one is visit our website. Step two is go to our enrollment tab. Three, complete the enrollment form, hit the submit button. And once you do that, and all the steps are completed, an enrollment specialist will contact you within 24 hours to do a follow-up enrollment process and ensure that your child is on our rosters. It's as easy as that. Once your child is enrolled in the program, parents will receive an email with all the information that you need to have, your enrollment information, how you log in, parent handbooks, student handbooks, all that information will be provided to you once enrollment is completed. If you don't have a computer or a Chromebook already, we will make arrangements for a pickup or delivery of technology to your home. And also for our K-5 students, for the curriculum program, they have additional online workbooks that would be sent home to them. So we know we did a brief session around HBLA, but if you have further questions, you can call 717-703-4364, which is our direct line to HBLA. You can also send us an email. So we've been receiving a lot of questions and around enrollment at our website. So it's there. It's also listed on our district website if you cannot find the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy site. And we will also be posting a lot of information and updates on the HVLA Facebook page.
So as Mr. Selmer had opened up this meeting in regards to, we are always trying to meet the needs of our families and our community and do our best to ensure that all our students are getting excellent education. We know that our parents have been very concerned about the opening of school, and we wanted to make sure that we had a premier option for all our students as well in terms of virtual learning from home. So if you are interested, please contact us at the email address that was provided on the previous screen, or you can call us and leave us a message and we would get back to you right away.
As Dr. Craig mentioned, during this serious COVID-19 pandemic, we are looking for ways to be able to offer more programming for our families. We want to be more fluid as a school district, and we want to be able to adjust to the needs of our community. This week, most likely on Thursday, I will be posting another PowerPoint presentation that will go through the opening of school and what it will look like for the 2021 school year. And you're going to see how this program really fits in to the pathway models that we are going to be offering for all our families in the Harrisburg School District. The second point I wanted to make is there's a lot of confusion around other cyber charter schools in the community. And if you have expressed interest in another cyber charter, if you signed up for another cyber charter, et cetera, and I want to make sure I clear those misperceptions during this informational session. So you are not locked in permanently to anything when it comes to your education. Specifically for cyber charter schools, even if you enrolled or expressed interest in enrolling, and now that we have an option that will compete head-to-head with those other educational cyber charter schools, you can come to HVLA. And I want to be very clear on that. No one can force you to stay in any educational program, specifically a cyber program. So if you've been told that, I'm going to be straight with you. That's not accurate, and it's not true. You can transition back to the Harrisburg School District at any point. If you have sought out a cyber option, you know, prior to HVLA, you are not locked into that option. All you need to do is contact us through the information and the resources Dr. Craig laid out on the PowerPoint, and we can walk you through that process to make sure that you're enrolled in HVLA, that you stay a Harrisburg School District student, you go through our educational programming, and ultimately you graduate with a Harrisburg School District diploma through HVLA, if that's your choice of education support and pathway for your students, student learners in your household. So I just wanted to make sure we're very clear with that, and that there's a clear understanding about what can and can't happen. And again, you can at any time enroll with HVLA, Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy, and we certainly want you to do so. We want you to be part of our family and stay within the Harrisburg School District. If you have students, families, and friends that may have not been with the Harrisburg School District the past year, 2 years, 3 years, and they have had a cyber option, they can enroll in this program as well. As long as you're a Harrisburg City resident, you can enroll in this program. It's at no cost to you. You get a free device, Chromebook, that will be supplied to you if you need it, and you'll get all the supports that Dr. Craig outlined in the presentation. The best way to get the information is what Dr. Craig mentioned earlier. We want to have one-on-one conversations with you through our enrollment team, through Dr. Craig and her office, so we can answer any individualized questions you have on a one-on-one basis. So again, we look forward to having that contact with you, that intimate contact with you as we move forward and we get closer to the start of school. And so Mr. I'm going to go ahead, Mr. Dr. Craig.
May I just make a clarification as well? I've received some emails as well about the curriculum, and I just wanted to be clear about the curriculum. A lot of parents have asked questions if the curriculum was going to look like what it did when we had to close in March, April, and May. And what I wanted to make sure you were clear on is that this is a K-12 curriculum that is offered through the Ingenuity platform. And you can go on to, if the videos don't play, or if you have time to visit the ingenuity.com website, you can go, it's free. You can look at the curriculum, look at what they are offering. Like we said earlier, it is a standards, it's aligned. All the curriculum is PA standards aligned. It is a full-time curriculum that we are offering, and not that Harrisburg is the only school district using Ingenuity. I believe there are over 40 other school districts that are using Ingenuity platform. We have used it in our other school, Cougar Academy, and it's been working very well. It is a very high quality, rigorous program. So I just wanted to make sure that all our families understood that this is not something we're kind of just putting together. It is something that already exists. It's been approved. It's PA core aligned. It's being used in other districts. This is what we will be using with our K-5 students who will be using the EDGE. It's called the EDGE program, but it's under Ingenuity. And for all our 6 to 12 students, they will be using Ingenuity middle school and high school program to provide their courses and also their electives.
Thank you, Dr. Craig. And that's a very important point you made. And the last point I'll make before we transition to Mr. Nornhol with the videos is that, the other piece that we want to do as a school district, and Dr. Craig touched on it, when the pandemic happened in March, everything shut down and everyone had to react quickly with the resources that were available. Since then, the district has worked very hard to be in a position where we can transition from an enrichment mode, which is what March, April, May was, to an instructional mode for the start of the 2021 school year. So as Dr. Craig mentioned, with the standard aligned curriculum, certified teachers, rigor with the programming, structure with the programming, those are the delineations that take you from an enrichment mode, which we were in the spring, to an instructional mode, which we will be moving forward as a school district. So again, we're excited about the transition. There's been a lot of work by Dr. Craig and her team to help us make that transition for the 2021 school year. And based on Dr. Craig's experience, her success with the Cougar Academy, she understands how to help and support our students and our families. And again, we're thankful that she's helping with the Harrisburg Virtual Learning Academy and will be a support to you, our families within the Harrisburg School District.
I just wanted to add to your point that in order for students to be successful online, we do need parents as partners to ensure that students are working regularly. Like I said, it is unlike what we did in March, April, and May. This virtual platform requires students to be working regularly to be able to make sure that they are getting high quality education and feedback that will continue to kind of to grow their learning. Also, you saw on both platforms that there were assessments built in. So our team of teachers and our success coaches will be monitoring students weekly and bi-weekly. We're working with MVP to ensure that parents are receiving reports. You are able to receive reports bi-weekly on the progress of your child so that you can keep track on whether your children are working towards course completion successfully completing their program. So we are working really hard to ensure that we have every aspect to ensure the success of your child in our virtual school. We can do so much, but we really need to work together to make sure that our students have the best online experience.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Craig. And I agree, the partnership will be critical. And we've done a great job as a school district and community partnering, specifically since the pandemic started in March. We've really come together and tried to work hard to support each other. And we'll need that same collaboration and teamwork and partnership as we roll out our new HVLA program. So again, Dr. Craig, thank you so much for your time, your expertise, and your passion and heart for hybrid and online learning. And we're, again, so thankful that you're you're leading these efforts and helping us provide this option for our families in the Harrisburg School District. So again, to our families, our community, thank you so much for taking time this afternoon to be with us. HVLA.us. If you go to HVLA.us, resources are there, contact information, the enrollment paperwork, etc. So you can reach us via, you know, Facebook. You can reach us via HVLA.us. You can reach us via a phone call. You can reach us via an email. So we have many different ways that we can connect to support you as you make your decision to come with us on this learning journey through HVLA. So again, I thank you for your time. I thank you for your continued support. There'll be additional information forthcoming on a weekly basis as we move closer to school. And again, please look at the end of the week, most likely on Thursday. There'll be another presentation that I will be providing to discuss the start of the 2021 school year and the pathways that we're going to be offering our families in the Harrisburg School District. So again, thank you so much for your time and your support.